I'm not supposed to show this, even to you. But under the circumstances, well, here it is. The chameleon jumps in.
Keeping a secret from me.
I began working on the prototype about a year ago. It utilizes holo technology, allowing an agent to assume any virtual disguise in its database. It was intended for your deep time research unit.
Someone performed a stream dive with it.
You'd be the first, but I suppose that's nothing new. Gage, if you go, Commissioner Baldwin may never grant you another command again, or worse.
Baldwin knows it's my job to preserve history, Will. He'll understand. If he doesn't, then I guess he'll be cellmates with Agent 3 when I get back.
All right. There's no time for a full diagnostic, but I need to see if the chameleon system works. You should now see a display within your helmet. Move your cursor over me. Use it to capture my image. Hurry. Good. Now my image is in your image database. Remember, you can only assume a form that is native to a time zone, which means you'll have to capture someone else's form when you're in the past. Also, you'll need to know how to initiate a temporal jump. There's a display at the top of the helmet that shows the date and the current time zone. Activate that and choose a location. You should only have one, the source of the distortion wave at 1262 BC. That's it. The rest is up to you. Good luck, Gage.
Gage, remember the smooth, sultry voice?
It's me, Arthur! The Robin to your Batman, the Jekyll to your... Heckle, the thing to your thing. Why the long face?
You remember me,
right? Dimples! Remember the... From your blank stare, I would say that you don't. Oh well, I'm not hurt. But if you don't mind, I'm gonna take a look around and make myself at home. While I'm checking things out, I have a message from your pen pal. Agent 3? Yes, Miss Joy. She left it for whoever found the suit.
My jumpsuit's the cause of the distortion wave. Once Arthur sends it to the TSA, the crisis will be over. I know everyone believes I'm a traitor, and I can't change that now. But what I have discovered is so incredible that I'm willing to turn myself in. But I can't risk being imprisoned before my discovery's investigated. So, you will follow my trail and see what I have seen. I have hidden three pieces of a time code that will lead you right to me. The first code piece is hidden in this environment, not far from here. Arthur has the coordinates for the other two time zones. You will soon figure out why I placed the codes where I did. In two of the environments, you want to go to the highest vantage point. But in the other, go to the lowest. I implore you, keep your eyes and your mind open, and remember that your first duty is to history.
The good news is, I know why you don't know me. The bad news is, you were mind-wiped. 2 months ago, you were taken from the past to help save your neck in the future. Together, we stopped Agent 3's plot to frame you. But I got zapped into the time stream with her in the process. Once your name was cleared, the TSA sent you back to your own time without any memory of the adventure, so you don't remember me. But we're back now. Together we'll find Agent 3 and bring her back alive! Oh, this will be more exciting than a pair of pants full of geckos! Just like before, I'll display icons for you to talk with me. If I have a comment, the thought icon will illuminate. If you want my sage advice, check the light bulb and see if I have any help. Oh, and I took the liberty of moving into the old translator biochip. So, I'll be your universal translator now. The new coordinates are in your jump menu. Lead on, Gage. That derelict boat seems to be in a hurry to leave the island. Hold on, there's somebody on that boat. He looks familiar. Call me time-space happy, but I swear that's Dr. Elliot Sinclair, the scientist who invented time travel. The guy you put away for 10 to 20 at Vega Thalen. He could be Sinclair's distant cousin. You know what that means. Baldness is hereditary. According to history, this uncharted island never existed. However, we are relatively close to Thera, an island that erupted in a huge volcanic explosion a few hundred years ago. The crater it left became the island of Santorini. The destruction of Thera had far-reaching consequences. From about 1950 to 1450 BC, the Minoans of Crete ruled the Mediterranean during the golden age of their civilization. When Thera erupted around 1450 BC, volcanic ash from 70 miles away covered Crete, while tidal waves flooded the island cities, wiping out the great Minoan nation. It was later proposed by archaeologists that the lost continent of Atlantis could have shared the same fate. This island isn't deserted, it's been attacked. Something destroyed the city's seawalls and flooded it. That Sirolan ship completely leveled that building. But the Sirolans are supposed to be the good guys. The founders of the Symbiotry. Why would our allies attack? We need to get to the bottom of this. Let me check out the time code. The time code you found is 1/3 of a temporal coordinate. With the other two pieces, I can triangulate Agent 3's location.
Well, you found one of the codes. I assume I have your interest piqued. Now, find the other pieces. There's still much more to see.
The nerve of her! Coming in here, taking over my space. Next thing you know, she'll be cleaning up my workbench. We're in a null time pocket, Gage.
Either Agent 3 has sent us to languish in a deep well, or we shrank into your turtleneck. Next time we vacation in the past, I'll bring my swim trunks. So what's next? Bungee jumping off the pyramids? Bull leaping in Crete? Whatever tore through here seemed intent on breaking and scorching everything. From what I can tell of the remains, the former culture was very advanced, and judging from the shape of this plateau, they mastered terrace farming techniques. Although they probably should have put more time into the fire department. Did you hear that noise? Sounds like there's some kind of commotion going on in the distance.
How typical. Every time we go to a theme park, all the good rides are closed. For once, I'm at a loss for words. I can't think of a reason why those piñatas are here. Pre-Columbian South American cultures were never really known to be avid balloonists. But then again, according to my knowledge of this time period, there was no record for this civilization. Do you hear a hissing noise? Yes, I'm quite aware of how annoying that is.
newcomer Gage Blackwood has roped a wild air balloon in under 6 seconds. That makes him our new rodeo grand champion.